Hello there! Today I have another top 10 video for you guys. This time we take a look back on the good old days. The days where you didn't have to think about the fuel efficiency of your car or the environment, because everything was okay back then. Everybody was cruising in their big V8s, living life to the fullest. And there we have already our first and main reason everybody likes these cars so much. By the title you already know what we are talking about. Of course, we talk about muscle cars today. Good old stinky leaking muscle cars. And because I don't want to wait for number one, we will do this list from first to last. Have fun and enjoy. Number one. Okay, I might have said this a couple of times already. But this is not one of my dream cars, but this is my dream car. This is the car which I was into even before I knew how a fucking engine worked. This is the car I have seen in movies and pictures when I was a little boy. This car is the personification of cool, sporty and at the same time elegant, big, loud. You see, I could go on for hours, but just look at this and say that this isn't the coolest, most badass looking car ever. The Ford Shelby GT500 Eleanor from 67 was marketed to have 335 horsepower, which we know by now was a little flux everybody did at the time, because of insurance. In reality, tests found out that the real power output was somewhere between 450 and 500 horsepower. Truly a legend. Number 2. This must be a little confusing for some, but let me explain. The reason why the Cobra Super Snake is in second place is because of the fact that there were only two made and one crashed and the other one was Carroll Shelby's personal drive. You could say his daily. And because this car was never actually available, I put it in second place. And I don't like cabriolets so much. Anyway, a big V8 putting out 800 horsepower sits under the hood of the $5.5 million valued car. Number 3. The Dodge Barracuda. Is a quite nice looking muscle car, if you have it in black of course. It's from 78, looks like a muscle car should look, big, sporty, cool, I like it. With 470 horsepower, it wasn't too slow for sure. Number 4. Honestly, before I made this video, I didn't even know that there is a Shelby 1000. But unlike the name suggests, this car has not exactly 1000 horsepower, but rather 1300. Why not? They must have thought at Shelby. And this model, till 2013, is the last good looking Mustang. Don't you agree? Or are you a fan of the new one? I mean, it doesn't look bad, but with a body kit, but I like the old one better. Number 5. Did you know when the Dodge Challenger RT came out in 1970, you only had to put around $3,000 on the table for one? Okay, inflation and stuff would make it more or less the same as if you would buy a new car today, but that's not the point. If it was today, I would buy myself 2 of those, or 2.5. Have to look at my bank account. It came out apparently with 335 horsepower. Number 6. One of the best looking cars ever. The Chevy Corvette 427 L88 from 1969. The same year we went to the moon and back. This car made its debut. Why isn't it high on the list? Don't know. Ask the guy who made it. Wait. That's also me? Anyway, it had quite remarkable 480 horsepower with its big V8. Number 7. Why is the Camaro under the Corvette? Because at these times I find the Corvette more attractive. Nowadays they would change places. Don't get me wrong, look at this beast. It is still badass looking and that's the reason why it's even on the list. But I like the old Corvette a bit better. Now about the Camaro ZL1 from 69. There's not much to say other than it had 500 horsepower and a big V8. And that's enough, I believe. Number 8. The Dodge Coronet Superstock is once again one of the first, and looks like one. It came with 540 horsepower under its hood, and considering it was first introduced in 1965, that's not bad at all. I would drive one, yes, but if I could choose, you know already. Number 9. The Ford Fairlane Thunderbolt was one of the first muscle cars, and therefore it looks like a family sedan with only two doors. But nothing not to like about this car. When it came out in 1964, it had between 500 and 600 horsepower. Quite exact. Number 10. The last one of our list is still an accomplishment. Because do you know how many cars didn't get a place on our list? A lot of cars. The Ford Galaxy 427 from 63 came with 425 horsepower, which is impressive for 63. I mean, we weren't on the moon by then. It too had this quite old, big ship-like design, but still counts as a true muscle car. Here we are once again. What's your favorite muscle car of all times? Tell us, and tell us also what cars or top 10 lists you want to see in the future. And just a reminder, a lot of those power stats here could be false. Because firstly, the manufacturer lied about the real power, and the people doing the test afterwards weren't so trustfully either. I looked it up, but it depends on where you go, you will find different power outputs for every car. I did my best, hopefully you understand. Have a great one, and as always, keep it fluid.